Welcome to English Succour. Let's look at the line by line explanation of the fourth part of the chapter The Enemy by Pearl S. Buck. If you're watching my video for the first time, then take a moment to subscribe the channel. And if you want to listen to the detailed explanation of the other chapters and poems, then you can find them in the form of playlist. Let's move on to the video now. In the story so far, we have seen that the servants at Dr. Sadao Hoki's house were not pleased with the presence of the American soldier. Moreover, Yumi was reluctant to wash the white man. And then it was Hannah who finally decides to wash the white man's body. So while she was thinking these thoughts, starting the procedure of washing the man, she found that the man was, he had a very nice texture, and she just thought that he might have been very fair or blonde when he was born and when he was a child. While she was thinking these thoughts, though not really liking the man better now that he was no longer a child, she thought rationally the very next moment, and then she kept on washing him until his upper body was quite clean. But she could not dare to turn the man over to clean his back. She didn't have enough courage to do so, and she didn't want to touch him more. And at this moment, she thought of Sadao, and she missed Sadao as she would have to take help of him. Now her anger was ebbing and she was anxious again, and she rose and she stood up, and when she stood up, she wiped her hands on the wrong towel. She just, instead of using a clean one, she used a blood-stained one. Then, lest the man be chilled, she put the quilt over him. This behavior of Hannah suggests that she was very much compassionate toward this man, not only this man, towards other human being, and she feared that the man will catch cold. So for this, she covered his body with a quilt, a bed cover. Sadao, and now this moment she was very much anxious, and she made a loud call for Sadao. And as soon as she just made the call and Sadao entered, he had been about to come in when she called, and his hand had been on the door, and now he opened the door, and she saw that Sadao had brought his surgeon's emergency kit and that he wore his surgeon's coat. So Sadao came there very well set to begin the procedure of operation. So she inquired did he decide to operate the man. So he answered in affirmative. Without wasting the time, he spoke shortly. He turned his back to her and unfolded a sterilized or disinfected towel upon the floor of the tokonoma alcove and put his instruments out upon it. Tokonoma alcove actually generally refers to a kind of structure or a kind of showcase. Especially in Japan, tokonoma alcove refers to a structure, a platform or a showcase that is used to display flower arrangement or any other showpieces or any piece of artistic value. Then he started commanding Hannah. Fetch towels, he said. He asked her to bring towels. She went obediently. She followed all the instructions of Sadao. But how anxious now to the linen shelves and took out the towels. There ought also to be old pieces of matting so that the blood would not ruin the fine floor covering. She feared that the blood will stain the fine, beautiful covering or carpet of the floor. So for this, she wanted to use some old pieces of matting. And immediately she went out to the back veranda where the gardener kept strips of matting with which and that mat strips of matting were used by the gardener to give a kind of protection to delicate shrubs or delicate plants, especially on cold nights. And then she went there to the garden and she brought armful of those strips of matting. But it was of no use because she was late. But when she went back into the room, she saw this was useless as the blood had already soaked through the packing in the man's wound and had ruined the mat under him. The carpet was already full of blood. Oh, the mat, she regretted for the ruin caused to the mat, she cried. Yes, it is ruined, said out, replied in a very simple manner without bothering about the damage caused to the mat, as though he didn't care. And then immediately ignoring that, as that was not important for him, he started giving the next instruction to her, help me to turn him, he ordered her. And she just obeyed him without a single word of protest or complaint. And he began to wash the man's back carefully. We must notice the behavior of Hannah towards Sadao as a wife, as an assistant here. Then, while Sadao was busy in washing the man's back, Hannah started having conversation with him, especially informing him that how Yumi expressed her reluctance to wash this man. And what did she inform him about Yumi's statement? That Yumi would not wash him. She said that Yumi refused to wash him. Then Sadao inquired that whether she had or Hannah had washed the man. And when he was making all these inquiries or when they both of them were having conversation, Sadao did not stop for a moment and his swift, concise movements continued without a pause. This brings out his intense involvement in his work. At his work. Yes, he said. Yes, she said. Yes, she informed that it was she who had cleaned the man. He did not seem to hear her. He was so much engrossed in his work that it seemed that he didn't hear her what she spoke. But she was used to his absorption, this kind of absorption when he was at work. And this is very normal with Sadao. Whenever he was very intensely lost in his work, he would never have any idea about what was going on in his surrounding. She wondered for a moment if it mattered to him what was the body upon which he worked so long, as it was for the work he did so excellently. She just thought for a moment that was it of any concern for him that the operation, the operation that he was doing for the man was actually an American man, an American prisoner of war. And actually she knew that this factor didn't bother him. You will have to give the anesthetic if he needs it, he said. The next instruction, he asked her to be ready to give anesthetic, or a kind of chloroform that is generally given to reduce pain. So she hesitated for a moment as she was not at all familiar and accustomed with this, and she repeated blankly that she never did so and she never did that work. To this Sadao replied that giving an anesthetic is very easy. He just lost his patience for a moment. He was taking out the packing now. He was removing the packing that he had done at the seashore. And when he did so, the blood began to flow more quickly with the speed. And then he peered into the wound with the bright surgeon's light that was fastened tied on his forehead. And then he said, it seems that the bullet is still there, he said with cool interest. Now, there was a cool interest in the attitude of Sadao as he was sure that the bullet, the cause of problem, was still inside and he will be able to find that bullet. Now, I wondered how deep this rock wound is. Now, the problem was that the man was first injured by a bullet, and his injuries further got aggravated by the rocks at the seashore. So, if it is not too deep, if the bullet is not too deep, it may be that he could get the bullet very easily. But the way the bleeding was taking place, it suggested that the bleeding was not superficial, or it was very deep. It was not superficial. It was very deep. He has lost much blood, he informed. At this moment, Hannah choked, because such a sight, the blood, flowing of blood, fresh blood, sight, she could not tolerate, and she felt choking, she felt suffocated. And here, when Sadao looked at her, he saw that her face turned into yellow color, just like sulfur, a yellow color element. And then he said, "Don't faint." He became a little strict towards her. He said sharply to her, "There is no need to be faint." He did not put down his exploring instrument, although Hannah was not comfortable and she felt suffocating. And then he said that if I stop now, the man will surely die. He could not stop in the middle of the procedure. She clapped her hands to her mouth and leaped up and jumped and ran out of the room, as it was intolerable for her. Outside in the garden, he heard that she went outside towards the garden, and here he could hear the sound of retching or vomiting, but he went on with his work. So at this moment, Sadao's helplessness had been brought out, that his own wife was in problem. She was not comfortable, she was unwell, but instead of attending to his wife, he was attending a man who was a patient, but a patient was an American soldier of war. So it will be better, but he thought that now he was a man, Sadao was a man who knew his priority. And it will be better for her to empty her stomach, he thought. He had forgotten that, of course, she had never seen an operation. But her problem, her distress, and his inability to go to her at once and be at her side made him a little impatient towards the man and a little irritable towards the man who was lying there in front of him, just like a dead person under his surgeon's knife. These are words with their meaning and synonyms. With this, we come to the end of this session. Thank you so much.